शारिपुत्र सर्वधर्माः शून्यता लक्षणा अनुत्पन्ना अनिरुद्धा अमला न विमला अनोना न परिपूर्णाः तस्मात् शारिपुत्र रूपं वंदनात् लक्षणा तस्मात् शारिपुत्र रूपं न वेदना न संज्ञा न संस्काराः न विज्ञा ज्ञानानि न रूपं गन्धरसस्त्रद्रव्यधर्माः न चक्षुश्रोतघ्राणजिह्वाकायमनांसि न चक्षुर्धातु यावन्न जरामरणं क्षयो न जरामरणं क्षयो न विद्या न विद्याक्षयो न विद्याक्षयो तत्रातित्वाद् बोधिसत्त्वस्य प्रजना पारमितामाश्रित्य विहरति चित्तावरणः चित्तावरणः माश्रित्यति निष्ठनिर्वाणः प्राप्तः तया व्यवस्थिताः सर्वबुद्धिः वृत्ताः प्रजना पारमितामाश्रित्य अनुत्तरां समकस्य सम्बोधिं सम्बुद्धाः तस्मज्जित्यं प्रजना पारमिता महामन्त्रो महाविद्यामन्त्रो अनुत्तरमन्त्रो असमसह मन्त्रो सर्वदुःखः प्रशमनः सत्यम् अभिवत्त्वात् सज्ञ पारमिता महाशित्य गते गते पारगते पारसंगते बोधिस्वाहा 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 गते गते पारगते पारसंगते बोधिस्वाहा
Mm-hmm. Namaste, Your Holiness. On behalf of the people of Bangalore, our donors, and Vana Foundation, our heartfelt welcome and deepest respects. It is our privilege to be in your presence, Your Holiness, for this talk on courage and compassion in the 21st century. My name is Veer Singh, and I happen to be the founder of Vana Foundation. Thank you to all of you for being here with us, and to those of you who have traveled from other cities in India. My apologies for the slightly tight and congested seating. I would like to thank our patron donor, Vana, our major donor, Manipal Education and Medical Group, our donor, Neelu Singh, for supporting today's auspicious gathering. Thank you also to our various contributors, including Gitanjali Sarangan, Snehadara Foundation, Nirav Dilip Shah, Mimansa at Foxtrot, Entrepreneurs Organization, Malika Suri, Shobha Narayan, Arjunjit Singh, the Prestige Group, and the Conrad Hotel team. Above all, I would like to thank you, Your Holiness, for your constant support to Vana Foundation's activities that strive towards a genuine revival of India's sublime ancient wisdom. We are grateful to you, Your Holiness, for provoking us to initiate Vidya Loke and thereby to share the Buddha's authentic wisdom in today's India. From our inaugural series in New Delhi early last year to the second series in Mumbai in December and now in Bangalore, over 6,000 people have had the opportunity to benefit from Your Holiness's wisdom through Vidya Loke. Friends and elders, in an era tainted with extreme individualism, mental suffering, and loss of genuine purpose, it seems almost unthinkable to explain the existence of an extraordinarily special human being, an absolutely selfless guru, such as His Holiness the Dalai Lama. And yet, it is within the reach of us to strive for our own enlightenment and give selflessly for the enlightenment of others. To do so, developing genuine compassion and courage to understand the ultimate truth form part of the efforts necessary. Let us now hear one of the most exemplary and beloved human beings of our generation, His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama.
Brothers and sisters, firstly, I want to make clear, I use this word, brothers, sisters, deliberately. Wherever I speak, I always start that. Because I feel sense of oneness of 7 billion human beings is something very important in order to create, firstly, peaceful world. Then secondly, individual peaceful mind. More altruism, think other. You see, that gives you inner strength, self-confidence, a lack of, I said, a genuine sense of concern of others' well-being. Think oneself. Almost whole universe, you are the center of the whole universe. then so you feel, oh, this side, or you feel some suspicion, some distrust, this side. So therefore, the no matter how rich and general modern education, lacking here, the ultimate source of inner strength, the person will not be happy person, calm person. So, one my commitment, number one commitment is try to promote a sense of oneness of 7 billion human beings. And I am practitioner of Buddha Dharma about Nalanda tradition. So our main practice is they think entire sentient being. We call buddhicitta. So you yourself, your physical, your speech, your mind dedicated for well-being of other. So as a practitioner, see, and then practical level, although we pray entire benefit for entire sentient being, but realistically speaking, other galaxies, we only pray, nothing can be done. Then this universe and this world also, you see the limitless birds, animals, some different sort of kinds of sort of mammals like that. But in practical level, only 7 billion human beings. We have human language. And we have this human brain. So although we pray entire sentient being, but practical level, we can share at least some of our own sort of kasuda.
Knowledge. Knowledge.
Or good wishes, right?
Yes.
Only 7 billion human beings. And then other hand, it is quite clear. Basic human nature, according scientists, more compassionate. It is very clear, very clear. As soon as we're born, the mainly mother and parent and some friends, you see, taking care of you, at least next, you see, few years. Without that, we can't survive. So now scientists say basic human nature is more compassionate. It's very true. However, 7 billion human beings, we, beside nature disaster, I think also is due to global warming. That's beyond our control. Then beside that problem, lot of problem, essentially our own creation is very true. In spite of basic nature, more compassionate species of mammal, because we are social animal. So loving kindness is the key factor to bring together. So any social animal, some level, that kind of sort of sense of community there. That's the, also the, so, because of the
basis for their survival.
Basis of their survival. However, a lot of problem, which